Hello everyone, and welcome back to the stream. I want to say it's been a while, but it's really only been 2 days. So, it's about time we go back to Spyro. And by about time, I mean... not that it has been some time, but we ought to... Oh, stop it, music. We ought to keep making progress. We had just entered a new world. We've saved 64 dragons, which is quite an impressive number. I'm not sure how many there are, but that sounds good at least. So let's get the preparing screen out of the way so you can see the game. There we are. Everything in working order. The game window here. Let's put the chat there. Professionalism. I am always prepared. So, there's the chat window. Well, no need to delay anymore, I think. Let's just get started. Hello, Onion Fighter? Is that how I pronounce it? Welcome. Right, so we entered the Dreamweaver's world and discover that it is very weird and has its own set of rules that boils down to most of the enemies having two shapes or states. In some stages it depended on the light, in some of them it seems to just happen at random, like here. Well, it probably doesn't happen at random, but I still need to figure out what the pattern is. Yeah, they've taught us how to deal with certain kinds of enemies, but now we've got enemies that switch from one state to the other. Which makes things a bit more complicated. But that's okay. Ow. I feel like that shouldn't have hit me, but... they make weird noises. Let's see. Have I been in here yet? Lofty Castle. I have. Though it's not complete yet, I do have all the dragons, which is what I mainly care about right now. I didn't actually get all the dragons in the Dark Passage, but that level is... it's quite a thing. Ah, we haven't even gone here yet. He almost kicked me there. Listen to all those gems. Oh, it's actually this thing that's making the noise. I was wondering what that was. Oh, hey, another dragon. Zikomo.
Hello, Spyro. Nicely done.
I'll be done when I've toasted that nasty Nork.
And that brings us up to 65. $300 more and we've got one for every day. Yeah, see, I don't quite see what's causing them to get small. Like in that other stage, it was pretty easy to figure out what with the... what with the light, like changing the dogs in the dark and such. Wow, that sounds... it sounds like I'm hallucinating. Haunted Towers, have we been there? No, we have not. Let's check it out. Well, this is a pile of armor, I guess. It does respond to my fire, but... we'll have to figure something out with that. Alright, so we cannot... We can't dash at him, but we also can't set him on fire. Interesting. We'll have to find another way. Maybe a dragon in this stage will tell us how we deal with those enemies. I just got squashed. Could I wear this armor somehow? I feel like they're trying to tell me something. Like, this is a bit too much for just a decorative object, isn't it? Can we just roll right into it? I guess not, then. Well, we'll figure it out. Alright, so the armor lies there, and it becomes animated by something. That's something to think about. Oh, hey. Ah, that makes sense. Super fire, I guess that would help against the armor. Yeah, very good, very good. It's actually been a while since we've seen that. That was all the way back in the second world, the Peacekeepers, wasn't it? Or was it in the Artisans? No, it wasn't the Peacekeepers world, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, give us another kiss there, ma'am. I still haven't found any use for these gems. We just kind of get them, and it looks nice, but I'd like some kind of a reward, some sort of incentive to get them. Maybe that's shallow of me that I want a reward, but what can I say? Perhaps in the balance between intrinsic and extrinsic rewards, I value the extrinsic too. Magic crafters, I see, thanks for telling me. I was kind of confused there. There we go. I wonder if there would be any point setting this one on fire. Because it doesn't look like he's gonna be activated by those... whatever they are, by the magic. It's clear that I don't understand all the rules of this world quite yet. Hey, that worked. Always explore the whole stage, that's important. Let me check if everything is still working properly. I think it's recording my voice, but I'm always unsure. Yeah, so it still seems to be working alright. I'll try not to stop playing to check the technical stuff too much, but... well, sometimes the stream just goes down for no reason. Then I have to go and fix it. And I don't want to be playing for a very long time without... it actually streaming, you know? I see, I may need to take some more of that fire over here. At least these guys aren't as scary as the spiders, those were freaky. I don't usually have a fear of spiders, but when they're very big and look a bit like beetles. The insect, not the band. Hey now. Taking hits left and right, I gotta be more careful. Let's get some more of that very hot fire. Okay, nice. Oh, keep running. Ah, I wanted to activate that too. Well, we might as well save this dragon now that we're here. Kozuko. Kozuko?
Hey, Spyro. All dragons know there's magic in a fairy's kiss. See what it can do to your power of flame.
66. We have reached the number of the beast. Minus 600. I wonder if the fire would do any good against this chest over here. I think so, but let's not forget that gem. Just listening to the music, it's pretty catchy. Oh yeah, flying right over. Okay, now let's activate this on time. Oh, that looks like it hurt, even though I don't think he actually hit me. I wonder if there's another fairy in this stage, because this is pretty far off, isn't it? Maybe that's the theme of this stage, is having a lot of those fairies. I'll try it once more, but if it's just too far away, I'll forge on ahead and see if we can find another fairy there. This can't be the only purple fairy around here. Oh, we're running out. Well, I got that guy, but that's about the extent of what I can do. There is, alright, thanks. Then I will keep moving on. Man, I love the colors of these locations. I think games that age poorly and games that age well are games where I fall into the ravine because I'm not paying attention. No, games that age well are generally defined, I think, by good color usage, because you know, the polygons and such, you just didn't have the processing power to make very complex 3D models, so inevitably they're going to age. But so long as you've got your colors right, it's always gonna have that flair. And I think Spyro has it. It looks very good even now. Like, just Spyro's design and the level of detail is a lot nicer than many of its contemporaries. Like, Mario 64 is, you know, probably a better game. I would have to analyze it, but the 3D models definitely aren't as nice as Spyro. Not to compare too much, you know what they say, comparison is the thief of joy, and everyone has their own taste, after all. Alright, that's a gem. Did I get you yet? I did. Okay, nice. He got me. So yeah, Spyro's design is nice and the level of detail on his model is good. There we go. We're getting a lot of use out of our abilities in this stage. I like that. Combining lots of different things together. I wonder if we'll have to use one of these pads with the fairy's fire at some point. That would be the logical escalation of this challenge if we're looking at it from a game design perspective. Bumped my head. Well, we can at least check what's over here. Ow. Ah, another purple fairy. Moi. I want to open all the doors first to see what's hidden behind each one. Let's get some more of that fire. Ooh, a treasure room. So many gems. Ah, another dragon. Lutalo, Lutalo.
Hold your horns. Here comes Spyro.
Patience, little one. You'll soon have the opportunity to battle the one who matters most, Nasty Nork.
67. Let's save the game. Want to make sure our progress is preserved. There is another door, but I wonder where this leads. There's still many places left to check, huh? Let's do the other door first, just to make sure. But I feel like the stage is branching out here. Always so many gems in those. Of course, we need many more where those came from. Kinda scary to be dashing so close to the edge, but we've got it under control. Maybe. Oh yeah, another extra life. Alright, that's where we came from. Okay, that makes sense. I'm glad I did this door first. That seems like the logical order of doing things. Let's get some more of that sacred flame. Oh yeah. Gotta stop dashing if you wanna make any kind of vertical distance. And there we go. We'll need some more of the fire, huh? Yeah, probably. Oh yeah, you see that green magic? I wonder if there's any way to prevent that from possessing... Oh, now we're stuck here. Oh, but fortunately the fairy is right here. Mwah. There is a secret room, you say. You mean back in the room with all the doors? Where we just came from? Because I can go back there if I missed something. Doesn't look like there's any more of those armor people here. Alright, this is just about the end of the line for this stage, so all we can do is go back and explore more. If you want to tell me where the secret room is, that's okay. You need the supercharge. Right, so what do I need to supercharge at? Like, maybe, is there anything very conspicuous here? The ramp, Well, I'll have a look. that wasn't quite what I intended. The ramp, let's check. Oh. You mean this one? This ramp? Oh. Because that's quite the distance to run if we need to go all the way over there. Well, I'll give it another shot. Not that one. All right. I'll have to, what? I do see the, some kind of hole up here. Oh, whoops. I don't see any other ramps I can reach from here. Like, I can't jump up here and maintain my momentum, I think. Unless there's another place to supercharge from. That isn't here. I can have a look around the stage. There's still a dragon to save, after all. This is just one of those fairies with fire. We might as well check behind here and see if there's anything. No? Okay, I guess not. What about on the other side? Let's be thorough. Let's be Spyro. Doesn't look like it either. Well, I haven't quite got it figured out yet, unfortunately. I don't think you could actually get here with the supercharge, and I also don't really see where we could reach with the supercharge. Maybe it's a good idea to return home for now and see what other stages there are. Ah, more than 8,000. That's pretty good, I think. Oh, whoops. Let's float upwards for a little bit. More of these guys. Alright, there's another portal there. I wonder if we've been there before. I think so, but let's give it a look anyway. Oh yeah, that's Dark Passage. Well, we are missing a few things from that stage, so we can always check. See if there's... if the solutions will present themselves to us. Ouch. That was quick. Snapping turtle. Yeah, this is a pretty interesting concept for a level where the creatures are scary, but only in the dark. We haven't been there. That's immediately apparent. Come on. Even as a snapping turtle, they're still pretty dangerous, though. Yeah, there wouldn't be enough distance to that jump. You probably have to get there through there somehow. I keep falling down, yeesh. Sorry. Trying to get a good angle here, but... Taking a few too many hits here. Okay, I can fly over there. Well, I almost dropped myself right down there. That would have been bad. I gotta be really careful about taking any more hits now. Come on. There we go. Let's get some of these mushrooms so we can get our health back. There, I feel much safer already. Let's get that firework out of the way. Just 5 gems, not quite... the impressive reward I was hoping for, but you know. Can't look a gift horse in the mouth. There's still many more gems to find in the stage, though. But I'm mainly concerned about those dragons, and there is one of them. Perhaps if we go down here, we'll get it. Ah, this is that path we were looking at earlier. Yeah, exactly. Oh, hey. I was just admiring the scenery and those dogs snuck up on me. They need to be trained better. Ow. Well, that sets us back a little bit, but it's fine. Let's just be more careful this time. Absolutely horrifying. They remind me a little bit of those creatures from Half-Life. The ones that make sound waves, I think. Those are also essentially a big walking mouth. Very creepy. Alright, we're back to where we started. Let's follow that path to its logical conclusion first, and then try that upward stream we just passed by. Okay. Looking good. This time we don't get attacked by literally all of the dogs. There we go. 7 lives, not bad. Alright, the turtles did me in last time. Or dragons. Depending on your perspective. There we go, no more turtles. Alright, where does this lead us? There's plenty more to see, huh? Another extra life. How very nice. That extra bit of security never hurts. He has a dragon to save there, so we're gonna head over to him shortly. Just gotta get all the gems here. Taking too many hits again. Good thing there's some mushrooms here to eat. Oh, is this where I would have come from had I taken the other route? Just would have come here from another place. Let's check, because that is an upward stream, so we might as well go down and see. Well, that was a sickening move on the camera's part. If we've still got our lunch with us, let's check once more. Oh no, this is actually where we came from. I got a bit confused about the geography there. That happens sometimes. Okay, anyway, it's been long coming, so let's save this dragon. A para. Apparently.
Thanks, Spyro. I'd love to help you catch Nasty, but I'd really hate being trapped in Crystal again.
Don't worry. The only one who's gonna be trapped is him.
68. Oh, I keep running into his ranged attack. I gotta be more careful. Oh man, now I can't take another hit. Time for extra cautious playing. From now on, I won't make a single move without thinking carefully about it. There we go. Look at that strategy. It's like I'm playing a turn-based RPG, except it's Spyro. I don't like the look of that room. I see a lot of dogs. You know what the dogs become when it's dark. Absolutely horrifying is what. Aha! My fire was faster. Spyro reigns supreme today. Ah, very good, a bit of health back, and there's the final dragon. Come on, eat it. Let's save him. Oh, Bossy.
Thank you for releasing me.
And now we've reached the ultimate number of dragons. Because we're almost at 70. And also 78% of the game complete. We have been going pretty fast, isn't it? This is just stream number 4 and we're already almost through it. Hey, Typlorsian, welcome to the stream. It's good to see you. We are now at 78%. We still have a few dragons left to save, though. And a lot of gems to find, but... So where does this lead? Oh right, this is another... Another passage. I was thinking we couldn't be done yet, considering the amount of gems we still need to get. Ow, still got hurt. No. And I will not have it. Oh. No, we've actually defeated these enemies before, haven't we? Yeah, we have. So where am I exactly? So the arrows don't destroy the chest either, huh? So I need to charge or have an enemy use an explosion or something on this. Oh, the projectiles seem to fall down, so I can't use those either. Well, what can you do? Yeah, at least I have all the dragons in this stage, so maybe it's smart to back out for a little bit and see what else there is to see. $8,400. Seems pretty good to me. Ow. That noise, though. Lofty Castle. We did do Lofty Castle and we even have all the dragons there, so I don't see any point in revisiting that right at this moment. Alright, that's where I want to go. I want to see if we can enter the next world yet. Not that I'm necessarily going to go there right away, but it's good to know what our goal is. Nom. Have you played this game before, Typlorsian? Just like Kazooie and Tooie, this game is completely new to me, so it's an interesting experience. Ow. Oh, years ago, I see. But you did play it. Cool. Jacques? Are we gonna find John here too? That's gonna be echtacular. Anyway, let's talk with the balloonist. Amos! That's a nice name. Nice job collecting so much stolen treasure, but beware, Spyro. Nasty's world is not the most friendly place you will find. Are you ready to go? Stay here. But at least the world is open now. So that's the last one. So Jacques is here. I'm guessing John is in the next world then. Confronting Jacques. What's he gonna do? Shoot lasers at me? Why do those guys hold flowers? That's strange. I guess it's interesting looking, but... Oh, whoops. Well, this is getting awkward. There we go. Man, the music here is quite intense, and look at that lava. Kind of hurting my eyes, it's so intense. Of course, we do want that gem. Oh, sorry. Been playing for this long and I still don't know how the camera works, apparently. There we go. Of course, we need to start at this one and not roll off. I'm guessing this guy will raise the platform if we hit him, so let's wait it out and grab some gems first. Okay, now that we're here. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. I also just noticed that these guys do not have legs. They just kind of stand there with their big arms holding a flower. Another gem. Whoa. Come now, Spyro, you can get up there. Or maybe he can't. There we go, of course he can. I never doubted you for a second, Spyro. Ah, there's a place to go into here. More of those arm guys. And a chest we need a key for. Alright, these guys need... I need to dash against these guys. 9 lives! We finally made it to cat level. Whoa, that almost went wrong there. I'll need to go back and get some of those gems I missed as a result, though. Yeah, I guess I deserved that. Shouldn't have run ahead. But it's okay, because what we've collected is still collected. Oh, they do have legs, you just don't see them. I can't believe I forgot that right after seeing it. I guess I kind of consider them separate enemies. I kind of mentioned this on another stream, but Spyro is definitely not one of those platformers you can play in a relaxed sort of way. Like, you can't get lax at all about your jumps. You need to be accurate and time your stuff, your jumps well all the time. It can't get complacent. Or it'll just drag on. Hehehe. I don't even know what that does. There's also something over here, so I guess I should do that too. So this is one of those cliche things to ask, but is everyone having a pleasant evening? When it's this time of year with the dark days, some weeks can be pretty heavy for people, so I hope everyone's doing all right. I'm kind of gonna reach that dragon, but I'm not sure how. Let's see here. I'm still wondering what this guy is for. That's what I thought. Hey, Arthur of Eld, welcome to the stream. It's good to see you. Oh, hey, a notification. Arthur of Eld, thank you for the follow. It's much appreciated. I hope you're having a good day or night or evening or whatever it is over there. Time zones. They're crazy. Missed that one by quite a bit. All right. Okay, this is the one. Nice, another dragon saved. Unica. Unica? Unica.
Thank you for releasing me.
Oh, hey, another notification. Unyuyun fighter. Also, thank you very much for the follow and for your help thus far. You're having a good morning. That's good to hear, Arthur. I wonder what this one activates. When I first found these guys, I thought they didn't even do anything. Clearly wasn't paying close enough attention. I have to revisit all the places I've been just to check what these guys do exactly in all their places. This doesn't look safe. I see what they want from me there. Oh, ouch. No more extra hits. We'd better do it right next time. F, what do you mean? Did the stream go down? It makes me nervous when people say, when people press F to pay respects. Another extra life, back up to 9. Very good. How many are there in this stage anyway? 500. But two dragons, so We're already halfway there when it comes to the actual dragons. Ah, right. That's alright. Okay. Oh, about the clock guys and me needing to revisit all the stuff, right? That makes a lot of sense. Sometimes I really miss the obvious. It happens sometimes. It must have been frustrating for Banjo-Kazooie and 2E fans to see me bumble through those games as well. Well, this was a press F moment, if there ever was one. At least I found a dragon and got a checkpoint, so it's not too bad. Well, there go all those lives I spent time gathering up. Oh well, that's what they're for, after all. I don't always know the right moment to activate the glide. I think I wait a bit too long sometimes. That's a bit awkward, isn't it? I don't want to have to start relying on the very evil, very naughty safe states, but I also don't want to waste too much of your time. Perhaps I need to elevate this platform somehow? Nah, that can't be it. I have to just be able to go over there, right? This time I did it earlier, right? That makes sense. We just had to do it earlier. Sometimes you try so hard to do it at the perfect moment that you end up missing the perfect moment. Like I was jumping and intently staring and then going up, you know. But that means he was already past the height of his arc. Of his parabole, whatever you want to call it. Anyway, that's more gems collected. Plenty more left to explore. Let's save, we don't want to lose all that delicious progress. Is that a bit too far to reach, perhaps? Or am I just doing something wrong again? As always, I was just doing something wrong. I should make a mental note to always activate the glide a bit earlier than I think I should activate it. Because I keep waiting too long. After all, there is a certain time between when you think you're pushing the button and when it's actually pushed down and received by the game. I did it again. Only 4 lives left. Maybe that one is just too far away, though I kind of died. Well, that wasn't even an attempt, that was just a goofy mistake. We're here now. None of that ever happened. If someone asks you how often I fell there, the answer is 0 times. Ugh. I knew I was doing it wrong the moment I tried it, but I flew over there anyway. Often what'll happen is I am overthinking the whole jump. Platformers are best played when you're not 100% focused on the game per se. Ah, see, this is what you're supposed to do. Aha. Let's knock this guy off of his pedestal. There we go. Looks like we're going in a circle, kind of, though, because we've already visited this area before. Oh, right, because we didn't actually go in here. I'm guessing the key is in here, too. Interesting. Let's not miss any of these gems. Last thing you want is to have, like, one or two gems left. Oh hey, there's the other dragon. That means we've already got all the dragons in this stage. Revilo, Revilo?
Any advice before this battle?
Advice? A wise dragon once told me, aim high in life, but watch out for flying boxes.
Huh?
Yeah, that was very puzzling advice. Flying boxes? What? Oh, I'm guessing that's Shock then. I guess he's a Jack in the Box. That's clever. A Jacques in the Box. I don't even know what that was, but it was interesting. Jack in the Box. Ow. So this is just one of those boss fights that's mostly the boss running away. Like a little baby. That's interesting. I always really like and hate boss battles where the boss chases you. It's very exciting but also a bit scary. You don't really remember the bosses from this game. That makes sense. They're like upgraded normal enemies. They're barely bosses at all. Well, maybe that's unfair to say, but they definitely don't feel very climactic or anything. Don't get their own music or health bar or title card or whatever. They're just kind of part of a larger stage. Whoa, that's a lot of damage, and that's a lot of gems as well. That puts us up to 435, leaving just 65 left to find here. And presumably there's another flight stage hidden somewhere in the Dreamweaver's world as well. We could have another look around. Completely intentional. That definitely wasn't an almost fatal mistake I made there. It was just an acrobatic maneuver of mine. Ah, right. I'm guessing the key is indeed the key to completing this stage now. But where is it? Perhaps I should return to those higher platforms once again and see if I can find a location I haven't visited yet from there. Though if I can't really find it, I won't be that broken up over it. Oh, But Spyro's head is about to be broken up because I keep hitting it into the wall. I thought maybe the key would be hidden behind there, but I guess not. I gotta listen to my own advice. Used to fly at the glide earlier. That's the big thing here. I don't see any places where the key might be. I think we've got this location kind of figured out, honestly. As part of the level, so it might be in that first segment where we've already been, but somewhere we missed. Okay, and early glide, there we go. If anyone does happen to know where the key is, I sure don't mind some tips and tricks, since I'm pretty sure we must have passed by it at one point here. Just missed it somehow. Oh, right, in there. There we go. Some proper exploration. And then I flew off the stage for no real reason. Got a bit too excited there. Now we only have one life left. Wait, he's back? Well, I don't care. Because I've got the key. And that should be it, right? Yeah, nice. 500 gems. Perfect. Well, let's get out of this stage. We almost have enough gems to do a dated meme. But I wonder how we can unlock the flight stage in this level. Well, there is still that one dragon left in Haunted Towers. I guess we can't just leave that one. I wasn't sure from the start if I was gonna do all the... Wait, which stage is this? Oh, Lofty Castle. I wasn't sure if I was going to do all the gems, but I definitely want to do all the dragons. Because they kind of hinted at that being important anyway, so, you know. I can't imagine there not being some kind of reward for that. Haunted Towers. In terms of its dream theme, this level definitely taps more into the nightmares than the good dreams. Okay, that's one more life, but How do we goad that magician fellow into shooting these guys? Because I can't seem to actually hit them. They can't be dashed into, and they also can't be set on fire. So at that point, we're kind of stuck. Maybe I can just force myself through it. Nope. They're like a wall. There's Jacques again. No, Amos, that's okay. Well, we could just fly over there from here. That puts us back near Lofty Castle, though, so not really any progress. Maybe I need to walk up to that mage somehow. They make such weird noises. It's like when you ask someone, hey, can you do an imitation of a crazy person? That's what they do. Just weird, incoherent gibberish. I'm guessing I can use this, right? Let's tilt it. That's a bit finicky, isn't it? There. So this is where the magic came from. I hadn't quite figured that one out yet. Well, as always, the solution is elegantly simple. So the flight stage will probably be up here then, right? I hope it won't be too difficult. Yeah, that looks like it. Quite hard to reach for a place in the hub world, but that makes sense. This is a late game hub after all. An extra life to compensate for our rather tragic losses in the last mission. Ah, I got it. We'll have to It would be nice if we could hit them in one go, but that's about as close as it's gonna get. Whoops, made that same mistake I always make and went into the glide too late. Muscle memory. There we go, better. Oh yeah, so many gems. We haven't even dropped any frames yet either on this stream. Like, the last few streams, he definitely had a few connection issues, which is weird, because this connection should be perfect. But there you have it. Today, we've got a good day in terms of connection. In fact, today is a pretty good day in general. Alright. Now we can do a dated meme, but I'm not sure if people are interested in dated memes at this point. Something about a power level, you know? Alright, this is just an explorative attempt, so we're not gonna try to actually win. We're gonna try to look how this level works. Just see how the shape of it works. There's no more of those little flying fellows here. Interesting. Let's move on then. As always, life hangs by a thread. Ah, I went in the wrong direction, didn't I? That's okay. So, we've got lights, chests, barrels, and copters. It's gonna take a few attempts for me to figure this out. I don't know where the rest of the copters are. Normally I would go against the trains, but maybe going with them is better. Yeah, in this situation it is better. Oh, whoops, I missed one. Not gonna be a great time at this rate, but I mostly just care about winning. It's not about winning, it's about having fun. Where's that final chest? Where's that chocolate cake? I've already seen the lights. Which... You mean in the flight stage? What? Missed. Yeah, let's just throw this attempt out with the garbage. So the lights may be something I have seen before, but haven't actually figured out is something I need to activate. Interesting. I'll try to keep an eye open. Miss again. So sloppy. Perhaps I missed that one last time? Oh no, another miss. At least we got all the copters. Alright, that was a decent run so far. We hear the silence of utter concentration. Oh, there it is, there it is. Of course, now I don't know where the rest of the stuff is. maybe going against the tracks might have been better. Let's check again. Oh, I see. Thanks for the tip. That makes a lot of sense. That's actually really useful because it'll give me a bit more time. And sometimes I overlook such obvious things. I mean, these are huge lanterns. Or lighthouses. I mean, it makes sense you would light them. Yeah, exactly. Lighthouses. I mean, they are over water, after all. I can't believe I got them lanterns. Clearly, my skills of recognition aren't as good as I want them to be. Oh, whoops, missed that one. Sloppy. And maybe prudent to go against the tracks right now. I can't believe I missed that. Come on. Yeah. Yeah, at least just one of the things left to do, but we didn't get that. We missed out on the copters, but at least we got all the copters before, so now we know what to do. I'm still gonna do the copters first, but now we got a pretty clear order of things, I think. That's a fun thing about these stages, you really have to figure out how the level works. There's an order of things, and the thing you see first isn't necessarily the thing you have to do first. It's all about reading the environment. Going with the motions. Oh, whoops. Sometimes you want to turn around so bad, you turn too much, and you end up in this cycle of going around your target. You know what's what that's like, right? Oh. Missed one of the chests. Sad. Disastrous. Oh, come on. Nah, we're not gonna make that on time. Perhaps the trains need to be done first. They're the wild card that I can't rely on. So let's turn around and go through this from a different angle. I also won the last flight by doing the trains first, so... Okay, one more. I missed. Doe, I missed. Now we have no trains to save us from the impending doom that is our time limit. Okay, there we go. We might be onto something there, but maybe not. Maybe we need to do the trains third and the copters last. Well, it was another very epic miss there. There we go. But now time is running out. Come on, where's that final chest? Ugh, missed it again. So close, and yet so far. Welcome to the Furious Button Tapping ASMR. Crashed. Yeah, we need to do both the chests and the lanterns in one go. I think there's no other way around it. I got confused by trying to do them both, but I also got confused by trying to separate them. Because it feels like you're doing the same thing twice. Because you are. Whoa, almost fell in there. Fell right into the drink. Which one did I miss? I missed one of the lanterns. Well, we'll figure that out when we figure it out. Let's just continue on like nothing happened. Could have made that one, but the fire didn't quite go where I wanted it to go. You probably still have the most time if we just do it normally. Normally, quote unquote. Alright, do it again. The curse of trying to turn too much and missing your target. There's one more train left. Question is where? There. Oh. Yeah, the train is still a wild card. We gotta figure out a better way to do this. The turnaround is so awkward, it's almost impossible that's actually what they intend you to do. There we go. More copter guys to kill. There we go. And there you go. I've turned around there. Oh, whoops, should have gone in the other direction. Messed that up. Messed it up real good. Oh well, that was pretty decent, I think. Come on, fly. There we go. And the third one. Okay. And now you're going down. There we go. And here's the rest of the helicopter guys. Good thing about the chests and the lighthouses is that they're all nearby each other. There we go again with the turning too much. This was the right direction, but we might not have enough time. Oh, I missed a few of the chests. That was really close though, very close. Just a little bit more and we've got this one. I don't know if I'm too close to the microphone. It'll be a bit awkward. Okay, that's the chest done. Okay. Lighthouses. Okay, this is clearly the best way to do it. I missed. Oh my gosh. That was such a good run too. I'm all flustered. If I were a Clue character, you could call me Colonel Mustard. Come on. Okay, we're gonna do it, we're gonna do it. That wasn't so hard, was it? Victory is ours. Nice. We do not want to try that again, no. Whoa. Spyro got a bit too close to the camera there. 300 more. Let's see. There are a few more gems to find here, I guess. Perhaps behind the portal? No. Well, it was worth a look anyway. Well, we already defeated that one once. So, what's next? There should be more. Oh, no, please. There we go. Slowly building up our reserves of lives again. Ow. We probably have to fly somewhere from the place where the magic cannon is, huh? It There we go. I have no idea how I survived that, let's be honest here. That was a very risky play there, but hey, it paid off. That's all that matters. So now I get to pretend that it was an informed decision and not a reckless suicidal move like it really was. Well, the final gem is up there. Oh, well. That was a lot easier than I thought. Once again, I overthought it. Come now. No need to be shy. Come, let me set you on fire. And there we go. That's all the gems for this overworld. Excellent. And here I was thinking I would have to use the cannon again or something. But nope. That was a non-canon solution, shall we say. Well, that means it's time to perhaps check out the next world. Because we have all the dragons here. Let's check the other worlds. Oh, we're still missing one of the dragons in the treetops, so... Before we go to the next world, we should check out the Beastmaker's world once again. Just gotta find the balloonist again. Wouldn't a balloonist be someone who is bigoted against balloons? I don't know how it works. Alright, we've gone all the way around and now we're back here. Alright, where are you, Marco? Polo. It's not Marco. The first balloonist was Marco, so now I just call them all Marco. Oh, hey, there goes our connection. Well, are we okay? Are we here? Are we there? Are we everywhere? Is the stream working once again? We had a bit of a dip there. Dropped a few frames. And also dropped right into the green, blue stuff. Looks like we've restabilized now, but that was, of course, inevitable. I had just praised how... terribly efficient our connection had been, so of course it had to be messing up. Okay, thanks for the feedback, Tablorsion. Hopefully it'll stay stable for now, because it did seem to dip a bit. I'll keep an eye on what OBS is doing. I just turned back when I saw the Jacques stage, because I didn't think the balloonist was here. That was a bit dumb of me. Hey, Amos. So, Beastmakers. All right, the chickens. And the electric people. I got a bit too close there. That's Terra's village. We've got most of that on lockdown, a few gems, but you know how it is. We'll look at those at one point. Let's get some health back. Oh, I don't even get to jump back out, just instant death. Yeah, the scene transitions are very nice. Quite impressive. Trouble in Terra's village, yeah. Is this treetops? Oh. Well, it certainly is me getting hit in the head by a misty bog. Now, we actually have that one perfectly complete. How nice. Nothing in here. I think there was something down here, but I don't remember which stage it was. Oh yeah, the wild flight. Well, we already did that, so no need to waste any time on that. Well, if there was any place where a treetop stage would be near the enormous tree, I guess. I like the background decorations here, like those little watchtowers in the distance. It's very cool. There we go. Treetops. So yeah, we have a dragon left to save here. Alright, the guys that throw bananas for some unholy reason. So is that running guy back here now? I wonder. Wow, that was just awkward and silly. Yeah, they make you they want you to dash after that guy, but then they punish you for dashing right away. Yeah, there is more than one running guy. There's one over there too. Oh darn, I lost my dash. But that's interesting. I don't think we've seen that before. An enemy that actually uses the uses the stage to its advantage like that. I feel like I had it there, but I guess the game thought I didn't. Thank you. And now we have zero lives. Thank you for that extra life. He's already waiting for us, smug guy that he is. There we go. You saw a chest I could charge, I see. I'll be on the lookout. Ow. Ain't that a kick in the head? Literally. How do I go about catching this guy? I wonder if you can catch him before he even gets to the supercharged slope. Did he just run to the other side? That's interesting. Where's the... I see the red one. Where's the green one? Now I'm confused. Oh, I hit him, didn't I? That's weird. Where did you go, Mr. Running Man? Probably way ahead of me, huh? Yeah. I needed that supercharge that I don't have now. And I got pelted with some bananas too. Well, where did you see the chest, Tyblorsion? Was it somewhere around here? I think I lost the running guy, so I might as well have a more careful look around. let's jump over here. I can also see the dragon we still need to save over there. First, let's get that charge back. I don't mean the credit card kind. Ah, there we go. How very convenient. Oh, it might have been another one. We're just gonna have another look anyway. There we go. We're back here now. Oh, the one near the exit. Do we need to somehow charge up there? Because it's on an elevated platform that I can't seem to reach by any normal means. I felt like I had to run towards it from somewhere, but I don't know from where. That's the main issue there. Oh. You don't have to charge there? All right. Ow. Bumped my head. I can reach it without charging, The way this ramp is set up, it seems like they want you to get it through the charge. Maybe a double charge or something. Though, maybe not. Oh, that charge isn't fast enough, so maybe I need a double charge. Yeah, I'm not sure either. Ah, well, we'll just keep exploring the stage. The most important thing is that I get that dragon, somehow. Yeah, I think that makes sense. The actual box you can probably just destroy by dashing into it if it's a normal metal box. Or maybe it's one of those that needs the key, maybe. Well, we'll figure something out. Alright, let's return to the start for a bit. And this time, let's go through the route we followed initially, where that green guy ran off to. Just not here, because this is death, but here. There we go. Where's that one island with the dragon we need to save? There it is. I wonder what the best vantage point would be to get to there. Because this kind of serves as a ramp already, so what if we somehow get from here? Spyro waves dejectedly, knowing that his end has come. Didn't happen. Okay, so what I'm thinking is let's ignore this jerk and not do that. Please excuse the gratuitous use of safe states. Yeah, that's probably not it either. Let's follow this guy for now. Okay, so that is how you get to the Dragon Island. That makes sense. Nope, no game over here. So, we now know how to get to that Dragon Island. Now we just need to actually get there. Oops. This isn't as easy as I thought it would be. I guess I still need to get used to the whole charging thing. Well, I lost my nerve and broke the charge. Glide after the last jump. Yeah, I think that's the way it's supposed to go, but oh, hey, a notification. I'm trying to glide, let's check. Raging White Wolf is now following. Welcome, Raging White Wolf. Thank you for following the stream. Kind of an awkward moment to follow on, but that's okay. Let's just head back in here. But yeah, it's probable that I need to get a good glide in right after that last jump. The problem is he seems to start falling or diving forward pretty quickly. Ouch. So here's something I'm interested in. Would people be interested in seeing the next few Spyro games as well? Because I've been considering my options as to what to stream next. And a logical choice would be the next Spyro, at least 2 and 3. But I'm not sure how people feel about that. Oh, I lost the green guy. That's weird. I was wondering why I couldn't figure out where to go, but the green guy somehow ran ahead of me there. You're cool with that, okay. Well, I might continue on to do the next Spyro then. It's interesting, they use those running enemies to give you the hidden eggs at first, but now he's actually just my secret instructor, helping me to figure out how to continue. Although, sure, go for it. Okay, cool, thanks. I'll there we go. This time I did the glide on time. And you're out of here, green guy. Okay, very good. That means we have the last dragon saved on this stage. Nice. Okay. Who are you, Mr. Dragon? Jed. Surprisingly normal name for a dragon.
That was quite a ride, Spyro. You've learned a lot since you were a young glider.
Yeah, well, you could have found an easier spot to get stuck.
I like that shrug, like, oh, whatever, man. He didn't like that comment. Jed, yeah. Jed the dragon. Let's see. That does it for all the dragons we can find up to this point. There are still a lot of gems left to find, but I think I'm gonna check out the next world for now, because we want to keep things nice and varied. Let's see, exit level, there we go. Alright, now we just need to find the balloonist again. Oh, there he is. I was making it sound like it was going to be some kind of nightmarish escapade to actually find him, but he's right over there. And I was being judgmental of him. I don't think he's a dragon, is he? What is he, actually? Anyway, we can go to Nasty's world, which, based on the shape of this, might be the last world. It sounds pretty nasty. Immediately a dragon to save, because I guess there's a checkpoint, so good stuff. Delbin!
Hey, didn't I already free you?
You're in Nasty's world now, Spyro. And you are the dragon who must defeat him.
Bring him on! I'm ready!
Reach the exit in each of Nasty's lands. Then you can challenge the Nork himself.
Alright, so we need to beat all the stages. We don't need to necessarily complete them, but we need to reach the end. The return home pad, I guess. Okay, that gives us an objective. And also gives us an indicator of how close to the end we are. It means next time could be the finale. Let's see. Nork Cove. I guess these all open one by one. This is not an explorable hub world, or rather, there isn't much to explore. Although there are 200 gems, so I'm guessing this will open up a bit after we start completing stages. So let's start with Nork Cove. These will probably be difficult stages. Already looks difficult just from looking at it. Oh hey, what is this, Donkey Kong? You throwing barrels at me? But you can still use the barrels somehow, interesting. Can't really stand on them though. It's good to know. Well, I guess Donkey Kong doesn't have a monopoly on barrel tossing, but that's what it reminds me the most of. Hey, Hagar, 1987, it's good to see you. Welcome to the stream. We just entered the final world of Banjo-Kazooie. Wow. Yeah, Banjo-Kazooie. Remember? The purple dragon. No, we've entered the last world of Spyro. Nasty's world. We've got about 85% completion. So, it's going well. How are you doing? Yeah, we can launch the barrels. Bam. You're good? That's good to hear. Ah, this is one of those things we need. There we go. So that's the mechanic for this world, or at least this level is tossing these barrels around. How long did it take me to get here? Asking the tough questions. This is the fourth stream. They've been about 3 hours apiece, so let's say 10, 11 hours? Not very quickly. It is a blind playthrough after all. I was looking at that and wondering what it was, but it was just a rat. Look at the heart underwear. Oh, almost forgot those gems there. Yeah, there are games that are quite short these days. Man, Banjo-Tooie took me so many streams. Because that game is ridiculously long. I'm actually grateful for playing something a bit shorter. Whoa. Oh, whoops. That almost was a really bad decision. Well, it was a bad decision, but there were no consequences, fortunately. Where's Mario when you need him? You couldn't get into Banjo 2. I guess I understand that. I really liked it, but it's a very different kind of game. Like, it's an interesting debate between those two games. Like, I've tried to articulate my thoughts on it, but I kind of like them both for their own virtues. But Banjo 2 is definitely slower. It's more about the puzzles and about re-exploring areas you've already done. Banjo-Kazooie is very compact, very simple. And that's also its greatest strength. So I like them both, but Latif... We saved Latif before, didn't we?
Keep up the good work, Spyro. I expect Nasty's really starting to worry about you.
I'd be shaking in my Nork boots if I were him. Nork boots.
We need to get a TNT to that place somehow, or at the very least a barrel. Lock, stock, and barrel. Well, that shouldn't be too hard. Just line up and dash. There we go. There's a little secret hidden there, isn't there? They thought they could hide it from me, but... Fortunately, I was on the lookout for little secrets. Oh, I'll... That's interesting. So you should fire at him and he holds it above his head, like... Oh... Would have been a bit easier to just use the barrel against him, but, you know. Another extra life, that's good, because we're gonna use up a lot of those in this world, I wouldn't doubt. Let's see, two. There are two dragons in this stage, so we need to find just one more. Ah, and this is just a normal front entrance. Okay, that all makes sense. Maybe this wasn't so much a secret as just another path. Ow. Gotta stop getting squashed by the barrels. Oh, he died before the TNT could get him. That was probably a mercy. After all, TNT is no joke. Okay, so we can't use the TNT barrels, because if you dash into them, they just hit you. We'll need to use the steel barrel up there, then. Kind of a weird angle, but we should be able to do it. Take this. I like that. Music here is catchy and upbeat. Not a really last level scary world kind of music, but I dig it, it's catchy. And I have to dig through the soundtrack and really pick out my favorites after we're done here. I already like the main theme a lot. It's interesting because you definitely noticed this was the start of CD-based gaming. That the music fades out and then restarts like that instead of looping endlessly. It's probably because it's actually an MP3. Well, I'm not sure if it's an MP3 file, but it's a some sort of music file. Ah, right, and this is when we get to throw that barrel. Okay, line up and perfect. Nice. See, the way ahead is right over here. I didn't really need to jump for that, but I decided to show off my dragon acrobatics. Another extra life, very good. There you go. A taste of your own medicine, doctor. Well, that didn't do very much. But that was a rather beautiful little domino effect. Oh, I died. That's a bit awkward, but you know what? It's fine. Those guys are only doing their job. Yeah, it's unfortunate. They're just working for the wrong guy. What can you do? We're on opposing sides now. If they attack me, I have no choice but to attack them. Such is the sad state of things. Truly, these are the horrors of war. Oh. Wow. Got all those extra lives and now I'm wasting them by getting sloppy with my platforming. Ow. There we go, back up to full health. Alright, this time we don't do ridiculous things and fall into the water. There we go. That wasn't so hard. There we go. We're having a barrel of laughs, you might say. There's another domino effect. Let's briefly check what's to see here. I like how you can overlook parts of the stage like that. It's nice. Probably part of the background, but still looks distinct, like you might be able to go there. Ah, there's the other dragon. Excellent. Thomas.
Wow, I never thought I'd be rescued, especially by such a little dragon. What I mean is, I always believed in you, Spyro.
You gotta believe.
That was a very odd and awkward interaction. It was time for Thomas to leave. He had seen everything. Haha. Oh, I almost missed that gem there. This looks ominous. But there is the end of the stage. Nice. Oh, of course, we need to use the barrel here. Seems like there's still many places left to go. Well, I know for a fact that you're going to get out of here, sir. Come on, another barrel, please. There we go. Now you only have your undies. Ah, hit them both. Nice. That was mostly for gems then. That's okay, we want the gems. Okay, so there's the end of the stage. There's still more we would like to explore if possible. Oh, but apparently it's not possible to get back from here. Oh, but we can still get back from here, though. That's good. It would have been pretty bad design if I couldn't. So I'm glad they thought of that. Or I would have been slightly upset, because there's still plenty to do here. Ah, look at that. 3-in-1. We don't really need this barrel for these chests. Ah, there's the key, but where's the chest? We'll have to look that up later. keep forgetting the rats are the food item in this stage. It's hard to imagine eating a rat. Right. This is the last place we haven't gone to. Ooh, this looks a little bit scary. Take that. Technically, you're eating butterflies. That's true. But it is a weird process by which the creatures in the stages turn into whatever food the dragonfly likes. Oh hey, all 400! We just perfectly completed the stage. Feels good, man. Oh, that doesn't feel good on the other hand. Bashing right into a big ol' barrel of TNT. That is the smart thing to do. Well, time to leave the stage and perhaps have a sneak peek at the next one. This seems to be the first world where you absolutely have to reach the end of the stage to open the next one. I killed a rat for no reason. Twilight Harbor. So this level has a bit of a harbor theme, because the last level was just like that. Ooh, 9,990. Ooh, listen to this music. Enemies with guns? Wow. It's definitely getting more technological than it was at first. Seems like the dragons are a more medieval society, and these nasties are more of a modern, or at least a more industrial society. They are called nasties, right? Yeah, yeah. Or, well, the guy, the leader is. That's fascinating. A lot of fantasy has the good guys being set as the less technological, more nature-oriented side. Lord of the Rings is one of the first popular pieces of fiction where the enemy, that is Sauron and Saruman, mostly employ industrial shenanigans. I almost said something smart there, but then I had to end it on shenanigans. Oh man. Look at this guy with the red beret. That's certainly something. Ah, dragon. Unfortunately, I am also army trained. You can't defeat me. Ah, rats. Cosmos!
Thank you for releasing me.
Soldier 76. I've got you in my sights. Wow. The knockback on those bombs is pretty ridiculous. And I just lost all my health. Let's save the game for a minute so we have a nice point to return to. Let me quickly check up on if the stream is still doing all right. Yeah, we also have several viewers. It's great to see all you guys here. I really do appreciate people taking the time to experience Spyro for the first time with me. I'm also going to have a quick look if Streamlabs has anything new to say that I might have missed. No, that seems to be in working order. Very good. Right, let's not delay anymore. Let's continue. So, I'm thinking we need those bombs that this guy throws to fall. Rip. We need those bombs to hit the chest somehow. But how are we gonna do that? How are we gonna get them close to the chest? Yeah, he doesn't have the range, so maybe we need a different solution. These are definitely some pretty intimidating enemies. They're focused, ranged, and powerful. They eat dragons for breakfast. Without milk. So those very nice sunset colors in the sky. I love that. Interesting. Oh, hey, a dragon. Oh, things have suddenly become quite clear. Anyway, Cletus again.
Be on the lookout for Nort Commando, Spyro.
They better be on the lookout for me.
77. That's 2 out of 2. Strictly speaking, all we gotta do is find the end and we're done here. This is a pretty big stage, though. I wonder where the end is. There's no need to rush anyway. Like I said, I'm not going out of my way to get all the gems, but if they're within my reach anyway, why avoid them? Let me know if I'm a bit too close to the microphone. I have a tendency to start closing. When I get concentrated on the game, I sometimes lean forward a bit too much. Stream this long and I still make some pretty basic mistakes sometimes. Please excuse me. Aha! Well, there goes the connection again. It's very unstable right now. Waiting to see if it'll recover. But at the same time, if you're watching this on YouTube, I don't want it to get boring, so kind of continue playing. Okay, that's the end of the stage. Let's go there and see what we can do. Okay, let's return home for now, because just typing to the chat that the connection is in a bit of a bad way. Gonna stop and then restart the stream. Now, last time this happened, I cut off in the YouTube version. And uploaded a... Uploaded the second part. This time, I'm gonna try and keep the recording one big thing. And try to have the stream as one separate thing. So I'm trying to stop the stream now, but OBS does this thing, or it takes very, very long to actually stop the stream. Okay, I think it just stopped. Okay, let's walk over to the next stage and get the chest. Nasty Nork. You mean that's the end? What about those other things? Okay, let's restart the stream. Hey there, everyone. Has the stream returned? Are we back in business? Are we alive? Okay, thanks, Typlorian, for keeping me updated. It's much appreciated. So, we just went out the exit of the last stage, and now a stage called Nasty Nork has opened up to us. Which is interesting. It sounds like it would be the boss. Confronting Nasty Nork, is this the end? Is this gonna be the finale? It's because there were two more dragon heads. Well, this could be the end then. Fascinating. There can't be only 77 dragons. Surely. So this is like the other. I thought maybe the final boss would be different, but apparently this works like the other bosses, where he's kind of an enemy in a larger stage, and it doesn't even do that much. That's okay. Is everything alright with my voice quality and the visuals on the stream? Can you see everything? Can you see forever? There is a whole 500 gems in this stage, so... Voice and video seems fine. Alright, thank you. Oh, he has a key. We should chase after this guy. Catch him somehow. We can get him with a blast of fire. Well, I think we're gaining on him, right? As long as we keep to the edges. There we go. Wait a minute. He had the key, right? Where's the key? Because we need to put it in here, right? Oh, it's up. Wow. That's a bit awkward, isn't it? Well, I hadn't expected to be doing the final boss on this stream, but sure. It's interesting. I mean, there are certainly two more stages to this world. Maybe it's like Kirby's Epic Yarn, where you do the final boss, and if you do it well enough, there's two more secret stages to do. Well, there we go anyway. I'll do the final boss's key last, I guess. Not sure if this one would have even worked, but... Oh, hey, another one. Yeah, let's make sure we don't actually miss something here. So that's the extent of the final bosses we chase after these fellas. Like we've done for so many segments of the game. Very interesting. I wonder if there's any secrets hidden here. Doesn't look like it. Just focusing purely on the challenge, I guess. Alright. Let's hope we don't catch him in midair again. And we don't bump our head. There we go. Much better. There isn't another door to use that on, is there? Okay, let's see what happens here. Oh, he just goes back like other bosses do. Oh, he just keeps running. You're pretty cowardly for a final boss there, Nork. Just briefly checking if there aren't any hidden gems around here. Except the one I'm playing, of course. Haha. Basically, just a lot of running, huh? I can't get up here. I'm not sure if there's any point to doing it. Oh, there is. Gems. Oh, no. I could have reached those normally. There was no point whatsoever. This isn't the kind of stage where they're gonna hide stuff on the edges. Just about running after Nork. And he just keeps running away. What a brave fella. This is where he just came from, right? So is he running in circles? Do we need to catch up to him like the other guys? Interesting. I'll have to figure something out about how to do this, because there haven't been any of those dash arrows. Supercharge. He's definitely faster than I am. And I almost fell off there. Can't keep running forever, or maybe you can. I guess when he stands up on that platform, that's your moment to take action. Maybe you just need to dash into him and not actually try to... He's a big enemy, so my instinct is to use fire and not get close. But maybe it's different for Nork. He is a final boss after all. I'm probably missing something here. That wasn't a hit. Of course it wasn't. Wouldn't be that easy. But it was close. And I keep almost falling off, which is almost very, also very close. Are there any dragons here? No. Maybe I'm missing something here. Oh, I need to do the key thing again too? That's a bit annoying. I'm missing by a lot. Yeah, let me ask. Is it actually... Are you supposed to shoot fire at him? Or am I completely missing the right solution here? So I think the idea is just to catch up and shoot fire at him, right? Isn't that what it is? You forgot. Alright, that's okay. Oh, you need to actually do the other one first. Of course. No simple solutions to be had here. Yeah, I'm really bad at aiming the fire, unfortunately. It's a problem, I know. At least the whole key thing is going a lot better. He's just a lot faster than I am at this time. It looked like bumping into him doesn't work, so I feel like we have to use the fire. Okay, so you say that it is a charge I need to do, Hagar. Oh, no, that's okay, no worries. Don't worry. I'll continue to try stuff. Perhaps there's something on the stage I'm missing. Due to the way the stage is shaped, though, you can't actually go back. Or can you? See, what if I return and... go against him now, like this. Better than just running after him all the time. This might work. Yeah, that makes sense. Based on the fact that we have some gems left to find, I'm guessing there will be another area to explore where we need to fight him. One last one. Oh, he's back up there. So cutting him off isn't that easy, apparently. Maybe I need to be more patient. Maybe I need to wait and see if he keeps attacking if we don't approach. He's kind of beating his chest, being proud of himself now. Oh. Right, so he's gonna do that attack, then we need to run up to him and immediately hit him with fire. I'm having some trouble due to the distance between the buttons. Going from dash to fire is a bit troublesome. I lack the dexterity. I'm too old already. Jump onto the platform. The one he's standing on, you mean? I just bumped my head into a pipe. I can try that. While charging, press jump. Then while in the air, let go of charge and press the flame button. We'll try that. We'll try that. Because after all, that jump... Oh. It kind of just ran off that time, unfortunately. Doesn't seem to always register the fire button in that context, oddly enough. Yeah, something like that, but quicker, that's probably it, yeah. Okay, we can figure this out, I just have to learn. There's a certain... I wonder if I could goad him into hitting something that would make him get hurt. Nah, it doesn't look like it. Almost died there. It's kind of hard to go from the jump into the fire for some reason. Maybe I should try sneaking up on him after all. Because outrunning him is definitely not an option on this part of the course. This part of the course. This part of the stage. I was gonna make a pun with bar for the course, but... That makes no sense. Oh, Well, gliding is making me slower. Yeah, that's possible. Yeah, we don't... I don't. Maybe the jump? We need to leave out the jump, maybe? I don't know. So long as I can switch quickly between the run and the flame, we're good. First one goes well, then the second one doesn't. Yeah, he's not that hard to catch up to. I do like that these enemies prepare you for what you're gonna have to do later. Yeah, so maybe we leave out the jump. Because, yeah, the jump kills our momentum, even... Okay, I'm gonna make a quick save state so you don't have to keep re-watching me doing that nonsense again. Okay, let's just run. Okay, no jumping, no gliding when we approach him. Just dash and flame and nothing else. I'm gonna try that combination now. See if that works out. Maybe it will, maybe it won't. Of course, right when I get close to him, it's not as fast as I normally do it. Sometimes he doesn't seem to do it. I jumped and I shouldn't have jumped. That's what happened there. At least we're kind of keeping up with him. There we go. That wasn't so hard. I just had to stop messing around. Thanks for all your advice, guys. It's much appreciated. And thanks for your patience with my very subpar performance. Okay. Now things are getting really tense. Oh, I see. Whoops. I just overwrote the save state, so we're back where we started. Yeesh. This final boss... Yeah, rip. I had to be a lot faster than I thought I had to be there, so... Yeah. Yep, rip save state, 2017 till 2017. What a shame. He will be missed, mostly by me. Wow, that wasn't too much trouble. This time, though, we should be extra careful not to do anything particularly dumb. Okay, so it's important that you keep up with him. Just storm straight at him. And then use the fire. That's how you do this. Okay, there we go. At least we've learned something from our mistakes now. Okay, so these platforms are gonna disappear. Okay, didn't happen. You didn't see it happen, I didn't see it happen. It's a secret. And there we go. Oh. You're toast, Nork.
Sorry I took so long. I kind of forgot about you.
What about Ganasty Gnork?
Nasty Nork is toast.
So now there's order again in the Dragon Kingdom?
Well, mostly. I've still got some treasure to pick up.
What will you do next?
I'd say the sky's the limit.
Well, 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 that was Spyro the Dragon. That was fun. Bit of a smaller, but still very entertaining collectathon. So now we're gonna have to decide what we'll do next. So either we're gonna continue right onto Spyro 2, or we're gonna clean up what's left of this game. You know, grab a few more collectibles, maybe check out those last two stages, whatever they are. Kind of depends on what people want. Like, is it are you particularly interested in seeing me grab all the gems, or would you prefer me to start Kirsten? Oh, that was an interesting name. There's a bonus level I can play now. All right, we're not gonna stop the stream until I check that out, I guess. I'll check that out, and then we'll decide if we're gonna continue or on or well, talking. Gonna continue on with this and finish it up. There is one more dragon to find in North Nexus, alright. Well, I definitely can't stop here without saving all the dragons. Unless saving all the dragons requires finding all the gems. Oh, a new one opens up, a new of the dragon heads opens up at 100%. Interesting. Oh, hey, voice actors. I don't think I know any of these people, but still, it's nice. Mike Gollum, interesting name. My precious and all that. Additional thanks. That's one step above special thanks, even. Derek Bauer. Ryan Beveridge. Is that a hot beverage or a cold beverage? No sheep were harmed during the creation of this game. Ooh, thank goodness. I wouldn't have been able to get over that. A few Norks, but no sheep. No, indeed. Returning home. Ah, right, so there's a dragon to save here now. Magnus!
Nasty's ancient history now. So, what's in there?
I believe this is Nasty's treasure hoard. But the gate will not open until you have found everything in the Dragon Kingdom. Come back when you have reached 100%.
Okay. Oh, we need to actually get 100% before we can actually do this, huh? Well, you know what? I'm not sure if we're gonna do everything, but now that we're here anyway, we might as well make a small dent in what we've still have left to complete. But I'm gonna have to... It's been 3 hours since we started the stream. Oh, Hawk. Hawk the Balloonist. Interesting name. That is a brand of canned things we have here, Hawk. So let's go back to the artisans. There's one level there that I still want to finish. I think that's all of the dragons, though. 78? You'd think that'd be like 80. Interesting. Wonder why they went for such a particular number. So... Stone Hill. We are missing a few gems on that stage. Now, this was in the early game, and I was like, oh, we're gonna learn a new move or something. But as it turns out, we do not learn any new moves here. So, that leads me to wonder where... where exactly are the gems? So... Nah. Alright, that's a new life. So I specifically know where they are, namely in this chest. So do you guys know where I picked this stage specifically? Because it would be easier to find the gems. So do you guys know where the key in this stage is? If you remember that, that would be very useful. Because I, for some reason, have been unable to find it, though it should be... pretty easy to find, since it is the first world. So if you guys remember where it is, that would be a big help. In the meantime, I'll just continue looking around and see if I can somehow find it by myself. Ouch. His pose when he gets floated up is also always pretty funny. Looks like he really doesn't want to be floated up. But then again, who does? So no one has any memory of where the key is in this stage? Because it's kind of awkward with these areas near the border where it's not quite clear where you can and can't go. So if someone remembers, that would make it a bit easier. That guy doesn't have the key. He had an egg. I don't think it's at this castle either. Either it's very well hidden, or it's just lying around somewhere and I keep missing it. The latter is a bit more likely, I guess. Maybe it's in one of these buildings that I use. Maybe you can enter one of them secretly. Ouch. Near the water, there is a cave. You mean... the water, like the ocean, or this stuff here? Wow, look at the way he rolls off. Oh, you looked it up, Typlorian? Do you, So is there a cave near the water? Near the edge here? Oh, hey, there it is. Or at least, yeah. Hey, thanks. Union Fighter or Onion Fighter. Onion? I feel like I keep saying it wrong. Anyways, thank you and thank you to Typlorian. It's much appreciated. Man, what a secret. Alright, that's the key. That means the final 10 gems will be in that treasure chest. Very nice. The rest of the gems are, I don't think they are in chests. So that's gonna be a bit harder to figure out. Like, these being in a chest is just very easy and convenient, but they can't all be that easy. And there we go. Completion. At least this world. Yep. ~93%. Well, we're gonna go through a few more stages, but we're getting about ready to call it a night. Let's look up Marco, the balloonist. And I love this. I love that they have this cool intro for the first boss. I don't know why they didn't do that for the other bosses. So cool and ominous to have like a big dragon mouth. My sense of direction is still as bad as ever, even though I've pretty much completed the game. There we go, there he is. The man of the hour, Marco. Let's go to Peacekeepers. Now, Peacekeepers is the least complete world, I think. In terms, I think I have like only one stage completed and the rest of them are half finished or less. There's even a dragon missing from the homeworld here. I forgot about that. Well, we can't stop until we have all the dragons, at least. Probably. Unless it's really hard to get them. So, I only figured this out this stream, but apparently you can use cannons like this. I had no idea. So that's pretty neato. I had no idea. Baboom. So that's fun. Let's see. Yeah, these stages are all only partially complete. We are actually also missing an egg from here. Yeah, there is a dragon missing, you're correct. I can't believe it took me this long to figure out you can use these cannons. There we go. Took me this long to figure it out, but hey. Better late than never, that's what they say. Pretty much my motto. Not really, but... Ah, right. Night flight. We haven't done this flight level yet. Well, we'll do that after we find the dragon in the home overworld here. The home overworld. Oh, there he is. And the egg, too. He's got the egg first. Or the key. Very good. Gunner.
Well done, Spyro! Keep up the good work, and I know you'll fulfill your destiny!
Destiny? I just want to kick some-
Just toast those enemies and collect the treasure!
Wow. He got really frustrated with Spyro for a second there. Silly dragon. Okay. There's plenty more to see. Like that. I have no idea what this is, but it looks interesting and secret. What's in here? Okay, it looks good. And that's all the treasure in this overworld. That's something. Nice, more progress. Let's get some health back by attacking these wild hares. Munch. And I guess the flight is a good way to close off the stream. So we're gonna do the flight, and then we're gonna call it a night. And that rhymed. And that means you know it's true. If it rhymes, it's always true. Okay, this will be interesting and awkward. Shouldn't be as hard as the last one, though. This is... logically, the second one, so... Oh. I can't believe I forgot the fire button. That probably cost me the attempt, but... Oh yeah, they have fairies holding arrows for the earlier ones. Alright, and what's left? Ah, the lighthouses. So that's why I got confused. I would have learned about them in this segment. Hello there, Zim Vendetta. Just secretly checked Streamlabs to see if you were indeed making a little naughty joke with your fake donation there. Oh, there I go. Yeah, it almost fooled me, but we don't even have a bot that actually says when donations happen. We don't have a bot for that, we only have the Streamlabs notifications. So I was just kind of waiting for the notification to tell me if it was real or not. Sim Vendetta over here playing with my feelings. How very cruel. Tempting a starving freelancer. Working into the late hours of the evening to stream. The dream of better days. I'm joking, by the way. Those lighthouses are one of the less recognizable things. I'll have to take extra care. Like, this is when I should do them, right? I don't think they're ordered in a particularly convenient way. I don't have a very clear grasp of the path the lighthouses are placed along. Yeah, I'm just gonna have a look around without actually trying to win here. So it looks like they're kind of circling around this cliff here. But then they stop, and then they move on to the next cliff. They're kind of within range of each other, but not quite. We'll need to have a... another look, maybe. Oh. I clicked the OBS window and was pushing the button, like, why isn't the game responding? But it was OBS. I was fooled by OBS. Yeah, this is probably not a good route to follow if you want to do the lighthouses. So which one did I miss? Oh, there? Of course, they can't make the last one easy. Even though this is strictly not even the last one. Okay. Yeah, that one I missed last time. Okay. So what is the logical next thing to do? Well, it would have been the arches, but I messed it up. Was terrible. I keep changing my mind on what to do and it messes me up. Gotta be decisive, specific, dedicated. No wishy-washy behavior. If you're building up time nicely, that's a sign you're doing pretty well, I think. Okay, so now I'm doing both the lighthouses and arches at once. Not sure if that strategy is gonna pay off, but no, it really isn't. I missed the one lighthouse and that really messed me up there. But it was very close though, very close. The last attempt probably would have succeeded if I hadn't missed that specific lighthouse. It's just that they're arranged in a pretty confusing way. I mean, that's kind of the point, so you have to remember it properly, but well, it's a reason, not an excuse. I missed it again, so that's bad. Maybe we should do the lights after all. Okay. Yeah, I really dislike the placement of those lights. Bit tough to get used to. Yeah, that might not work. Oh, game got tabbed again. I guess we'll throw that attempt. Crashed. If I can find a logical order to do them in, this is way better than going all the way around at least, so that's a start. Maybe I need to do it in a circle and not try to zigzag. Yeah, that's it. Okay, I guess we'll do the chests now. But just a bit too far out from the arch. Shame. But I think I might be onto something with this structure. See, now that I know the logical way to do those things, maybe I can just do it in the way I had originally planned. Because really, all those different orders were just a way to circumvent me having to actually remember a proper structure. But now that I kind of know how it works, I think I'm gonna be fine. We've put in the hours, we've done the research. It's time to conquer this stage. Okay. Now, only the lighthouses remain, but we don't have much room for error here. Oh, I already missed one. I already missed one. Not much room for error, he says, as he makes an error. Yeah, that's it. I ruined the attempt by missing the first few. Me, oh my, it sure is challenging. Feels like no order is really optimal, or maybe I just need to do the arches last. Because they are the more logically ordered set of things. Yeah, you know what? We're gonna do the arches last. Okay, that was a big screw up. Oh man, of course I had to say this was the last thing I would do. Then I can't finish it. Nope. Not even gonna bother if I keep missing that last ring. It's just too awkward to even live with. With that thought, Spyro dove into the ocean, never to be seen again. Maybe I should do both the arches and the lighthouses after all. Okay, yes! Excellent. How nice. Well, that does it for that challenge then. Returning home. With 300 treasure in the bag. Bringing us up to 11,000. Well, let me check once more if we've got all the dragons for real. No, we are missing one in Haunted Towers. Darn. I was about to pretend that wasn't the case. I figured there had to be 80. Well, maybe I'll get it, maybe I won't. Gosnold? I already knew his name was Gosmold, I just pretended to be surprised. Because it's such a weird name. Flying Dragon rides in the flying balloon. Oh, wrong world. Wow. Dream Weavers. Oh, and now we've been dropped off at the wrong place, so we need to go look up the balloonist again. Well, if we just hurry up, it won't be too hard to find him. Ow. There he is. As full of hot air as always. Once again, the crazy noises. There's Haunted Towers. At least fortune favors us in terms of finding the level. Alright, again with the kisses. So there is one more dragon here. I think we already checked behind this building, but... we might as well have another quick look. Oh hey, near the start of the stream, someone hinted that there was a secret room I needed to dash into. but I couldn't find it. Maybe that's where the final dragon is. So there's a little bit where you have to use that super dash or supercharge or whatever it's called. And we could somehow use that to find the secret room. I saw some green on the other side, so I'm gonna very sneakily fly around and check. Okay, I don't think that was it. So, does anyone happen to know the last location of the dragon in this stage? The last, dragon? He hit me, but he didn't hit me. You heard the noise inside the building, you say? Of course, the question is, how do we... actually get to it? Yeah, you can dash down here, but... doesn't seem to be a logical path to follow to any secret room. I guess it wouldn't make sense if a secret room had a logical path to follow, but... someone said you have to do this, but then they left. So now I don't know what the rest of it is. When your run gets interrupted by a fairy wanting to kiss you. The one that leads outside. So this one or the other one? This one. Like, there's one that leads to a sort of grassy area, and one that leads to a more, stony area. Alright. Well, we're gonna give it a shot. Well, I don't know how I did this or what the point of that was, but... Oh, hey! Interesting. So there is a chest here. Eh. Oh, well, there is the dragon. Thanks for the tip, Copano.
You've become a master of the supercharge. Great work!
And that's 80. Very good. Of course, there seems to be plenty left to discover here, but I think that's a good place to end it off. Because we've been going for a whopping 3 hours and, oh, ouch, 40 minutes. So I think it's about time to call it done, at least for this time. And this is, you fall through here and you get back into that base, that room near the start. Okay, now we know how to get there, so if we decide to come back to this game, we may do some cleanup. Otherwise, we'll probably go and continue on Spyro 2. So, I'm gonna reflect upon what to do for the next stream. But that is the main series of Spyro, or rather the main streaming series of completing the main story completed. So, thanks a ton to everyone who joined. Thanks to Union Fighter. Thanks to Tyblorsian. To Hagar1987. Clive couldn't make it today, but thanks to him too for being at the streams. Thanks to Arthur of Eld for visiting the stream. And let's see, we had several new followers. So you know what? Let's close the game down. And let's list off the new people who followed us. Yeah, get out of here, silly guy. I'm just looking for a save point. There we go. Okay, there we go, closing it really caused it to crash. So let's turn on the preparing screen again while we say our closing words. So like I said, thanks to all of you guys who joined us. There have been many people who didn't so much talk in the chat, but who did view the stream. And I support. I really appreciate everyone's support, including people who just watch. And Arthur of Eld, Union Fighter, and Raging White Wolf get a special shout out. And the Sick Thing, who followed, I think, between the streams, for following. You guys make it a fun experience. Like, when I started streaming, I wasn't sure about it, but I think people around helps a lot. So, with all that said, that's the stream. Have a good night, and I will see you next time.